Breast cancer is on the forefront of any woman's mind, and now many women are finding out if they're at risk for breast cancer thanks to a DNA test that is more widely available. Here to tell us how Scottsdale Medical Imaging is helping women across the valley is Dr. Denise Reddy and Shanna Levy, genetic counselor at the Virginia G. Piper Cancer Center. Good morning, you two. Thanks for joining us. Shanna, let me start with you. What do we know about these breast cancer genes?
Well, what we know now is that there are a great number of genes available to be tested. It's not just BRCA1 and 2 anymore. So we can look at this range of different genes that are out there that can predispose women to not just breast cancer, ovarian cancer, uterine cancer, thyroid cancer. And what we would do with that information is tailor different people's screening, surgical options based on their unique genetic makeup.
Okay, and we have a graphic here that we want to show people of what it looks like with what. So tell me about this graphic.
So this is specific to ovarian cancer, and you can see that about 3/4 of the time, if we know someone has a mutation, it's going to be one of the BRCA2, one or two genes. These are the genes that were first related to hereditary breast and ovarian cancer in women, and they've gotten a lot of attention in the media and medicine, but we're now finding 1/4 of the time that there are other genes involved and they can predispose to other cancers.
Dr. Reddy, let me ask you, Scottsdale Medical Imaging are known to be experts in mammography. How did you get involved with this, with the genetic testing?
That's a good question. In December of 2013, the United States Preventive Task Force recommended that women with a family history of breast cancer or ovarian cancer undergo testing for the BRCA gene mutation. Now, most women, 90% of women, don't need the testing, but in the small percentage of women that do potentially have that mutation, they have a very high risk of breast cancer. Every month at SMIL, we screen thousands of women for breast cancer, and we play a big part in their breast health. So we realized we're in a good position to help identify those women who may benefit from the testing.
And tell me, how does this program work? What does SMIL do?
So when a woman comes in for her screening mammogram, she's going to fill out a short medical history sheet, and on it there are 4 or 5 very specific family history questions. And we use those questions to help us screen for risk factors that suggest that maybe there's a BRCA mutation or a gene mutation in a family. Now, the radiologists aren't experts in genetic counseling, so then we help identify women who might benefit from the testing and refer them to people like Shanna for that counseling.
And let me ask you, I mean, when a woman is referred to you, what happens next?
So the first step for any patient, man or woman, is that they fill out a family history questionnaire. So we use that information to see what's in their family history and what's in their medical history and how do we tailor our discussion to that specific patient. And then after that, they come in, we talk for about 1.5 hours. We go through what kind of tests are available, if they're interested in testing, because not everyone is, and what they would do with that information, whether it's for surgery, screening, telling family members, and also sort of the psychosocial issues that come along with that cancer is no easy thing to be dealing with, and there's a lot of issues that go along with that we can talk about during our counseling.
And you're there to guide them along the way. And Dr. Reddy, let me ask you, I mean, we always talk about how important it is to get a mammogram. How can we use mammograms and this genetic testing hand in hand? Can they work together?
Right. So the goal of this program would to help bring awareness to thousands of women that there is a genetic risk for breast cancer and to help us identify who would benefit from that cancer. And we know that women who are at a higher risk for breast cancer benefit the most from mammography. So what we're trying to do is help personalize their screening. By using genetic information and information we get from the mammogram, we can help tailor the kind of screening that women need and help them better understand their own breast cancer risk.
And quickly, what age should women really start getting the mammograms and looking into this?
At the age of 40, they need to get their mammogram starting then every year.
All right, ladies, thank you so much. A lot of important information out there that I think a lot of women don't even know that all these things are available. So if you want to find out more information about this important topic, you can visit getamammo.com or call the number you see right there on your screen.
Up next, we'll tell